Come on, sisters, let's get down. I don't die, fam.
When we first moved to England, we lived with my aunt and uncle and their three kids who were older than us. They were really into the younger cousins. The two were punks. And then my oldest cousin was into electro and things like that. The first time I had ever seen anybody do a tag, my cousin was doing punk tags, and his name's Tom, but he did like a T, a hashtag, and an M.
We were like, whoa, what's he doing? He's writing on something that's not his.
But then he was really into The Clash, so he took us to go see a Futura piece. And we didn't know what it was at the time. He was like, he wasn't into graffiti. That made us interested in that. So then we started looking at graffiti, you know. And then on his estate one morning, we were walking to school, because they used to walk us to school. We saw this funk piece that it was like Afro character with goggle glasses. And we were like, what the fuck? I turned around to my cousin and I was like, oh, what does funk mean? And he was like, oh, it's some bullshit soul music. Because he was into punk and ska, so. But me and my brother were like, wow, that's the best thing I've ever seen. And then my friend's brother got Subway art, and he wouldn't really let us look at it. Because in like 84, English punk was dying, and so was ska. And all the music that was coming out at that time was all like shit pop music to me. For me, but I was listening to kind of punk and ska and bits of reggae, so we were being taught stuff at an early age where most of the music at that time was like, I love you so much because you can dance. But then, so we started like, my mum's boyfriend was from New York and he bought us like, you remember those Walkman radios? Me and my brother used to listen to hip hop radio stations, and then one day I took my earphones off and I realized he was listening to the same thing, and I was like, you listen to hip-hop? And he was like, yeah, I really like it. He was like, yeah, so do I. And then we both realized that we liked hip-hop. We didn't start doing graffiti for years, really. Yeah. Do you know what I mean? Like, we started doing shit tags in like 88, 89. We were originally trying to read it because in South London most of the tags were like quite wild stuff. We had to kind of figure out how to read them.
Yeah, and then
we started realizing that dudes from our neighborhood were in central London, and people that something was done, so you would go to a neighborhood and walk around all day trying to find the piece, and then when you found it, you were holy shit.
Yeah.
We were like looking at it, like trying to figure out how they did stuff. All of the best graffiti was in the worst neighborhoods.
For us, we realized that punk was dying and that hip hop was the new punk. And it was our age group. If you look at when I was 11, LL Cool J was 18 years old. So his music I could relate to because he was still young. Mm. Do you know what I mean? Like, that's the kind of age group that I'm at. So, you know what I mean? Like, no, but you know, like hip hop for me was it was the new punk, and it made me feel like I could be part of that, even though with graffiti that people didn't know what I looked like. Like, so later on, years later, when I started telling people who I was, they were like, "Oh, I thought you were a massive black guy." And it was because I guess most of my tags were in South London and around Brixton area.
I love that.
I think when you're born, your bum put your fertilizer in your foot, in your feet, because mate, you're tall. Today we walked for the train, you banged your head on the bloody ceiling.
Honestly, it's like, I like the fact that the anonymity of graph, like, it's still, even now, it's just a thing.
Yeah, but the reason why I started sticking my face on everything at that, maybe like fucking 10 years ago, was that I was doing so many youth projects that I was doing lots of stuff for different religious groups. And I realized that certain religious groups wouldn't allow me to work with their children if I had anything dodgy with me. So I knew that.
That's a fine line.
What's
though,
no pit bulls now? You can't stand up and go, "Listen, this is me and Sam."
No, but you know what I mean? Like,
me and Sam. Yeah.
You know, I wasn't taught how to teach. But I knew from my bad schooling as a kid that how to talk to people. Graffiti is a way of looking at things in a different way. Like, sometimes you'll get a punch in the mouth or whatever.
I've never done that.
No, but you know, you know, of course not.
Just say that.
Yeah, just in case.
Just in case you're the one who haters
it. Just in case you're
worried. That's never going to happen.
No, but you know what I mean? Like, it grounds you, do you know what I mean? It puts you in a position to deal with actual life.
Yeah.
Through it, besides graffiti, like, you can do things where people tell you you can't do it.
Okay.
So that means that you can, if you do graffiti, then you can then become whatever you want to be.
That's
because you realize
said.
That yeah. you can be that thing.